Today is Saturday, August 20th, 2016, and one of these three players will be our champion. But for now, players, you are the challengers.
Today's game, we have three great contestants. Let's go ahead, before we start the main game, let's go ahead and get a chance to introduce you. So let's start with you, Lorenzo. Tell us a little bit about yourself and where you're from.
I'm from the Bronx.
Woo! And what do you do outside of anime conventions?
Well, I work as a security guard at 7 World Trade Center.
Woo! And let's go on ahead to Kevin. Tell us a bit about yourself.
Well, I'm a Nintendo gamer, and I've been to some conventions. I've been to quite a few conventions. My next convention, which it will be September, called a Video Game Con. Anyone
going? I heard about that convention. All right, sir. And let's go ahead to Peter.
My name is Peter, and I'm trying to grow hair, obviously. I'm Jasmine's father.
Oh, yay.
So she was back.
Rosa didn't see our trump card game.
All right. Well, players, welcome to the challenge. It's the name of the game. Like I said, we're going to try to get yourself some money by answering questions about today's current anime, as well as more recent events inside the anime industry. But before we begin, let's go ahead and start off with the challenge sprint. So to go ahead and get you guys started, I'm going to give you guys all $200. Now, I have to warn you, every single question in this game will wager your money. In this first round, in the next 60 seconds, every single question that you guys get correct will give you $100. Every single question you get wrong will cost you $100. Go ahead and have your hands on your buzzers. We play this first to the buzzer, and then they'll get the first answer. All right. We have 60 seconds on the clock. Clock begins countdown after I finish reading through the first question. Best of luck to everybody. Name the instrument that is played by Link in Legend of Zelda series.
Peter.
Give me an answer.
The guitar. No. I really almost what we was looking for. In the Gauntlet franchise, archers traditionally wear what color outfit?
Peter.
That is Peter.
Green.
Okay. Yes.
Yep.
Yes.
And this week, a new trailer showed an hour footage from the 15th installment of what Square Enix franchise? Peter again? No, Leon Lorenzo this time. Need an answer.
Final Fantasy.
That's correct. And Cardcaptor Sakura, who designs all the outfits that Sakura wears? No guess? Moving on, that would be Tamayo. What fighting game was responsible for the creation of the entertainment software Ratings Review Board? Peter.
Mortal Kombat?
That's correct. In the anime's title, name the boy dubbed the Mightiest Disciple. And that is time in this round. That last answer to the question was Kenichi. Looking at the scores, Peter, you're tied with Lorenzo in first with 300.
All right, we have to break that tie because we have to have somebody in the lead.
So we're going to go to the next question.
You lay back for me.
All right, so Kevin, this question is, you hang back. Lorenzo and Peter, this question is for you. Let's go to the next one. What do you call a group of people in public who perform a spontaneous choreographed dance number? Lorenzo.
Flash mob.
That is correct. And that is our tie. So Lorenzo, you're in third. Peter, you're in second with 3. Kevin, you're in third with 300. As we get ready to play our first round, let me just one slight thing, because I think you muted yourself.
I was trying to get sound.
Yeah. There we go. Okay. So as we go ahead and move on into our first round, so here's how this is going to work. Lorenzo, since you're in the control, you're going to have your first pick of these six categories, and they are the dating game, Silver Sonic, and that is, of course, in honor of the Sonic the Hedgehog's 25th anniversary, Bullseye, with reference to any artist in popular culture, the Hollywood Connection, current events industries category, from A to DBZ, I should not have to tell you what that one is, and Triple Threats. All right, I'm going to give you three of something. You're going to tell me what they make up. Now, inside each of these will be a separate question for each, will be three separate questions. You guys will have to use your buzzers here to go ahead and select which question you guys want to choose. If all three of you manage to go ahead and choose Two more of you choose the same question. We're going to have a toss-up between you two to go and decide which one gets the money for that question. If all three of you choose the same exact category, all the dollar amounts on the board will go ahead and double up, and we will go first to the buzzer. Otherwise, I will ask each question individually, starting from the top. Now, if you are the first, if you are the person who chooses the solo question, we obviously default to you. But there's a little bonus involved running the entire table if we get to that point. We'll talk about that in a moment. All right, so Lorenzo, since you are in first place, you get to go ahead the first category of your choosing.
I like bullseye.
Okay, we're going to bullseye. And your three categories for players, you're going to choose from Archers and comic books, Archers and video games, and Archers and anime. Push the button on your little joysticks corresponding to the color of the one that you want to answer.
You see, the blue will be Archers and comic books, the orange is Archers and video games, and the green is Archers and anime.
Right.
So you choose the one you want.
Okay, so Kevin, you're playing the solo question, Archers and video games. Peter and Lorenzo, we're going to play the toss-up right now with Archers and comic books. So heads up for you two. Archers and comic books. Now with his own TV series currently airing on the CW, Oliver Queen is the real-life identity of what comic book superhero?
Peter.
Robin. No!
I'm a green.
No!
You said it first.
I know. What's the team want?
Green Arrow.
Yes! Thank you.
I have no idea.
We lose 150. We give you the 150 over to Lorenzo since he gave us the right answer. We now go to Kevin for Archers and Video Games. In the original Legend of Zelda games, Link's bow provides the finishing blow to Ganon when it is equipped with what type of arrows?
Light arrow?
No, I can't
not
take that
original,
one.
No,
silver.
Oh,
silver.
All right. Lorenzo gave the last correct answer.
So Lorenzo, you get to go back to the main board and you get to pick from the remaining six.
Let's go from A to DBZ.
From A to DBZ. All right, these are all questions I have to deal with Dragon Ball Z. You can choose from Dragon Ball Z, Dragon Ball Super, or Dragon Ball Evolution. Alright, once again, Dragon Ball Z for Lorenzo. Peter chose Dragon Ball Z, so we're going to go with the first one, worth $150. Dragon Ball Z takes place 5 years after the original Dragon Ball, where he is now a father of two with his wife named who? Peter? There you go. Wait for me to call you in.
Be careful.
We're going to call you in. 300. So Kevin, this question is for you about Dragon Ball Super. Dragon Ball Super's most major threat comes in the form of Beerus, who arrives on Earth along with his assistant and a teacher named who?
A teacher named Whis?
That's correct.
We got it. Yes.
All right, we give you $200 for that one. All right, so Kevin, you get to now get to pick the next category of these remaining four categories.
Silver Sonic.
All right. These are all questions relating back to Sonic the Hedgehog's 25th anniversary. You could choose from his game adventures, his animated escapades, or his friends. Ooh. And Peter? All right. Once again, Peter and Lorenzo for $250. We go with the one at the top of the ladder. That's his game adventures. This question's for Kevin. All right. His game adventures. Sonic the Hedgehog's gaming adventures began in 1991 when he first game debuted on what video game system?
Genesis.
Well, I'll take that. That's correct. All right. Toss up between Peter and Lorenzo in the category of his friends. In the Archie comic books, one of Sonic's best friends and longtime love interest is the princess of the planet Mobius. Name her. Not taking a guess? Alright. We're gonna buzz you out on that one. The answer was, of course, Sally, or in the original adaptation, Acorn. Alright, so Kevin, since you gave us the last correct answer, you're gonna pick from the remaining three.
Triple threat?
Alright. I'm going to give you guys three of something. You guys are going to pick from either heroes, best friends, or villains.
Choices.
Heroes. All right, in that case, since all three of you chose the same one, we're going to double up all the remaining values, and the person who gets this correct will go ahead and try to play off for the remaining $900 on that board. So,
if they wish to,
of course. Players, all of you are playing this one, so hands on your buzzers. In the question of heroes, what is the collective name of the three pint-sized superheroes named Blossom, Bubbles, and Butter?
Lorenzo?
I believe that's the Powerpuff Girls.
That is correct. All right, you get to go for 300. We're going to clear the board. Now, Lorenzo, you do have the right to go ahead and choose from best friends and villains and run the table if you like.
So you can choose either
you
one
can choose
of those.
Either one
if you want,
go.
Or you can stop here and go to another category.
You're going to go with best friends.
Take it.
But for 400, in the Pokemon series, best friends Ash, Misty, and Brock all hail from what region? You gotta give me answers.
Where are you from?
Yo.
No answer? No answer. All right, so we're gonna take away 400. The correct answer to that was, of course, the Kanto region. All right, really the last question unturned. Let's go back since...
Okay, he's still looking at
the next one. So you have two categories remaining between a Hollywood connection and a dating game.
Yeah,
you may want to hold on to it just in case.
Let's go with the dating game.
You want to go with the dating game? All right. And you guys can go ahead and help us with these three categories. And Tenchi Maski, or Tenchi Muyo. Tsukene and Ayano, or Rosaria and Vampire. And Kitara and Urashima, you love Ina. Tenchi? Tenchi and... Question is in Tenchi Muyo. Players hands on your buzzers. Tenchi copes with the affections of several women within his castle. The two most prominent ladies that battle with each other are the refined Princess Ayaka and what crass space prince pirate? Anybody? Anybody? No guess? All right, nobody gets a guess at the question. The answer was, of course, Ryoko, the space pirate Ryoko. All right, Hollywood Connection is the last category left, so you can go ahead and choose from these three. Pokemon, Power Rangers, or commercials? Players, lock them in now. Pokemon, Power Rangers, and Pokemon again. So we're gonna start with the $150 question in Pokemon. This question is for Peter and for Kevin. Legendary Entertainment, the company producing next year's live action Pokemon movie, are reportedly in script writing talks this week with Alex Hirsch, the creator of what recently concluded Disney Channel cartoon.
I told you. It's the show I would like to watch.
No guess? Alright, no guess on that one.
Alright, I hear you, Jasmine. Okay, now if you want to put out a mystery, what is it?
Gravity Falls.
Thank you.
Alright. Power Rangers, $200 question. This question is for Lorenzo alone. Alright. Lorenzo for Power Rangers. At last week's Power Morphicon convention, the cast for the newest Power Rangers TV series was just announced. What is the title of this new series? No guess? Yep. Try to take a guess. Say something. No? No guess? Alright. The answer to that one was, of course, Ninja Steel. And at the end of the first round, we have Kevin in the lead with 350, Peter in the lead with 300, and Lorenzo in the lead with Lizarin in third with $250. So, of course, we're going to come back after this brief commercial break where anything happened in our second round right after this. Second round of the challenges. We have a good, tight, close game, I guess you could say. Kevin in the lead with 350, only $50 ahead of Peter with 300, and Lorenzo trailing behind with $250 as we play our next six categories, and they are Pokemon Going and Going, Treasure Hunt, Sailor Moon Then and Now, The Big Spin, and Shoot for the Stars, and New This Week. Of course, it's being stuff that came out recently in this last week. Now, Kevin, since you were in the lead, you have to go ahead and pick up.
Wait. Who had the last correct answer? I gotta go back a little bit, because Lorenzo, I believe, had the last correct answer, so he's still in control.
Yeah, Lorenzo, so you have to pick from these six. Pokemon Going and Gone, Treasure Hunt, Sailor Moon Then and Now, The Big Spin, Shoot for the Stars, and New This Week.
Let's go with New This Week.
New This Week, all right. These are questions about stuff that came out or was recently announced this past week. Of course, films, characters, or anime episodes. Pick your choices.
Films.
Yeah, there we go. Everybody chose the same question, so we're going to play the same question as a toss-up. This one is worth $600 now. This is in new films. On Thursday, this past Thursday, a new Japanese live-action film due out in 2018 was announced that will adopt the manga of what long-running supernatural series?
Oh,
Peter.
No.
Do one of the other two players want to play?
Oh, wow, you got a negative
there. I got a negative.
Kevin Lorenzo, you want to take a guess? No?
The anybody out there know?
Anybody out there know what?
Bleach.
Bleach.
Yes. Thank you. Yes. All right. Peter's down in a hole by 300.
You can come back. You can
still come back. So come back. Kevin with 350 and Lorenzo with 250. And Lorenzo, you still get the twos.
Shoot for the stars.
Shoot for the stars. Alright. Pick from these three space relays: Star Fox, Outlaw Star, or Mystery Science Theater 3000.
Star Fox. Oh.
It's still on you. Pick one of those three. Alright, Star Fox. Alright, so we're gonna start off with a $300 question. This is a toss-up between Peter and Kevin. And Star Fox. In the Star Fox series, the aircraft flown by Fox and his crew in battle are known as what? That is Kevin.
Are we?
That is correct. All right, count up to 650. Lorenzo, you get the solo question for Outlaw Star for 400. One of Gene Starwin's crew members aboard the Outlaw Star is Aisha, who represents a race of beings known as the Katara Katar. What type of animal do they resemble? Want to take a guess?
Tigers.
I would accept
take that
answer.
We'll take that.
I would accept that.
Cat
I
would
have said big cats too.
Yeah, cat was what we was looking
for. Yeah, that was a toss up in my head.
Yeah.
Right, so you're up to 650 tied with Kevin, and since you gave us the last correct answer, you get to go ahead and pick from the remaining four.
Pokemon.
It's going to get picked at some point.
Not Pokemon.
The big spin.
All right. These all talk about that spin, starting with spinning moves, spinning objects, or spinning wheels.
The big spin.
And all right.
Okay. What's going on, Sol?
This question is for Kevin and Lorenzo. We're going to start with the $300 question of spinning moves. What weather-like name is given to the spinning foot attack of Ryu and Ken in the Street Fighter video game? Lorenzo. No guess? I gotta call time, it's 2 seconds.
Yeah.
Call time. Alright. So, Kevin, you wanna take a guess at it?
Wait. He's still eligible.
Kevin?
You don't say anything yet.
I'll repeat the question for you.
You can
what weather-like name is given to the spinning foot attack that Ryu and Ken in the Street Fighter video games?
You can pass it.
I'm gonna take a pass.
Okay. Now you can say it out there.
Tatsumaki.
I'll take that and...
Hurricane Kid.
Okay, all right. Hurricane or Dragon Gale. Okay.
Yeah.
All right, yeah. You said Tatsumaki.
I'll take that. Yeah, I'll take that, sure. All right. This question is the solo question for a player in spinning objects. While most people spin a bow staff as a weapon, what Nintendo character can spin his bow for an attack called the Angel Wing?
Oh, man.
He can still guess, right?
Wait, he has to play it.
Oh,
so.
He has to play this one. Yeah, you have to play this one.
You got something?
Oh, it is. Oh, he's a little guy with wings.
You see it in your head. You just can't think of the name.
Oh, Frank.
We have to call time. I have to call time. The answer was Pip or Kid Icarus.
Kid Icarus.
Okay, so we'll be back. Lorenzo, you still gave us the last correct answer, so you get to be in control. Your categories are Sailor Moon, Zen and Now, Pokemon Going and Going, and Treasure Hunt.
Pokemon.
Just
get it
all,
boys.
Okay, players
only
the buzzers. Your questions are about the Pokemon games and they relate to the tricks.
Well, particularly as predicted, Pokemon Go. These are all about.
Yes. The tricks, the teams, or the exclusive Pokemon.
Teams.
All right. Doubling up on the teams. This question is for all players for $800 now.
If any of them mess this up, it's on you guys. You talk to this
one. All right, here we go. Question is coming. Hands on your buzzers. Trainers in Pokemon Go join either Team Instinct, Mystic, or Valor. Each leg. I'll finish reading the full question for the remaining two players. Trainers in Pokemon Go can join either Team Instinct, Mystic, or Valor, each led by its own captain. What is the name of the captain of Team Mystic? Lorenzo.
Blanche.
That is correct. You are off by just a little.
I don't even play the game.
All right. free throw for him?
No, wait.
Does he want to try one of the others? Right. You can switch for it now.
You're
you can choose from the exclusive or
okay,
the
okay.
You're playing it safe? All right. So as we look at score now, Peter, you're in the whole $1,500.
Negatively, I'm ahead.
Kevin, $650, and Lorenzo at $1,150. Lorenzo, you still get the next question. Sailor Moon or Treasure Hunt?
My sister annoyed me with this throughout my entire childhood, so Sailor Moon.
All right, let's go Sailor Moon. All right. You can pick the year of 1992, the first season, 1995, Sailor Moon Super S, or 2014, Sailor Moon Crystal. Make your choices. All right. Now, just as a point of advice, Peter, you desperately need this panel. All right. And to at least stay in the game mathematically. All right, the question is from the first season, 1992. During the first season of Sailor Moon, Usagi idolizes the heroine similar to her known as Sailor V, which since she turns out to be the girl who acted as Sailor V. All right, I'll read it back. During the first season of Sailor Moon, Usagi or Serena idolizes the heroine similar to her known as Sailor V. Which Senshi turns out to be the girl who acted as Sailor V. It is so easy. Now watch this. Were you in the bag?
Sailor Venus.
There you go. Sailor V, Sailor Venus. I kind of thought the two decided. All right, we're to the floor. All right, we go to our last category now, Treasure Hunt. And the questions are Pirate Booty, Artifacts, or gemstones?
To the booty.
Pirate booty. You decide what you want.
He's Kevin and Peter, Pirate Booty and Lorenzo.
Booty.
All right, this is about famous treasures.
Why did we lose control of this game?
I don't know. This is a puzzle for all three players. Players, hands on your buzzers. This question is about treasures. The legendary treasure of One Piece is said to be located somewhere within what famous region? Peter, you need a guess. Anyone want to take a guess at it? Anybody in the audience know?
Grand Pan.
What was that?
Grand Line.
Yes. That is correct. That would have been correct. All right. So at the end of the game, we have...
Two.
Well, at the end of round two. Oh, that's correct. Well, we have one more round, but unfortunately, one of our players won't be able to come.
It's not me, right?
Well, let's look at the scoreboard. Lorenzo, you have 1150, so that's definitely a positive number. That is $650. That is definitely a positive number. So, Peter, with negative 1,500, I'm afraid we have to say goodbye to you. It's definitely hard. Well, you're a legend in our own minds, but they're not a legend in the game anymore, so we have to say goodbye to you. But we'll definitely give you something for playing. Give it up for Peter, ladies. All right. Here's our lucky two to do with this.
Mm-hmm. All right, well, here, take a break first, and then we'll explain.
I'll take a break right now. Okay. So here's how this is going to work. For our final round, Kevin and Lorenzo, you'll be wagering your money Final Jeopardy style on topics of this category. Taking on the final challenge as we play. Wait a second. There we go. And the final challenge category for this game is Nintendo All-Stars. So these three questions are going to relate back to Nintendo All-Stars, and the way how this works is going to work Jeopardy style. You're going to write down your choice of what category and how much of your remaining money you want to wager. Now, bearing in mind, though, if you both choose the same category, only the person that puts up more money is going to be the one that gets to play the question. So your three choices are Mario. Mario, if you choose this category, we'll go ahead and give you even money if you get it correct. The Legend of Zelda, where we will double your wager if you are correct. And Metroid, where we will triple your money if you guys are correct. So go on ahead and write down, write down both your category choice and how much money of your $650 or your $1,150, and we'll find out how they do when we come back. The answers to the show's questions have been researched independently via various wikis and, of course, the Source series. Headlines and news information is accurate as of the original taping date of this episode, and some material was sourced at Anime News Network Online. Visit AnimeNewsNetwork.com for the latest news and coverage focusing on Japanese animation and Japanese comics. We went ahead and we had you guys choose one of these three categories, either Mario, questions relating to Mario, questions relating to The Legend of Zelda, or questions relating to Metroid, and here are the results of that.
We'll start with Kevin.
Kevin,
what you picked. Just tell us what you picked.
I picked Mario.
And for how much?
$350.
Okay, that's even money. Now, if Lorenzo chose the same question, but he chose more than $350, then he's going to get the one to play this. Which one did you choose, Lorenzo?
I selected Mario.
And for how much did you wager?
$1,000.
All right, so unfortunately, Kevin, that means your score is going to be stayed at the $650 as we clear it off real quick.
Actually, I don't have the ability to clear it, so we're just
going
to...
Oh, yeah. No, you do.
We'll figure it out later.
Yeah. Lorenzo, this question is going to be for you. If you get this question correctly, I'm going to give you another $1,000 on top of your score. Okay. The game that was originally titled Super Mario Bros. 2 was originally exclusive to Japan in 1986. American gamers would not play it until 1994 when it was released as part of an All-Stars pack under a different title. What was this alternate title? And Lorenzo, this question is for you. Any answer at all. Going once, going twice. I'm gonna have to call time. I have to call time with you, sir. All right. So you lose $1,000, and that should score back to $150, which means Kevin is actually our grand champion for today. Before I say the answer, some of you guys had your hands raised. What was it? He's right there.
Doki Doki Panic?
No, sir. Super Mario the Lost Levels. Yeah. Super Mario 2 was re-released in the Super Mario's All-Stars pack as the Lost Levels. You can also see a bunch of people.
Did you know that one?
Yeah, I knew that
one. Yeah, okay. See, that's a problem. But, Kevin, you're still our grand champion with $650.
But we have a house minimum in this game of $2,500.
That's correct. So we're gonna bump that up to $2,500. Lorenzo, you stay at the $150, but we're still gonna give you something just for coming out. And of course, Peter, you're still getting something just for being in.
Okay, $100. Yeah, because we established this with you guys last time you did this. One other important note, Kevin, because now you are a champion. You have the potential in this to, when we play this somewhere else later on down the line, you may continue your to defend your title. And if you should win three games in a row, you will then qualify to take a chance at the Ultimate Challenge for in-game money, an additional $25,000, which would mean an extra $250 in prizes. That's if you win three games in a row. So you've taken the first step toward the Ultimate Challenge, so we will see you sometime soon so that you can defend your championship. Study up in the meantime.
Number 3, thank you guys for coming out this weekend. It has been a great crowd.
Some prizes were provided by Geek Depot, offering minifigures, patches, watches, toys, and anything cool that appeals to geeks far and wide. Visit them at facebook.com/mygeekdepot and find out why at Geek Depot we love geeks. And from Sanchi, a selection of plushies from their Five Nights at Freddy's collection, along with other officially licensed premium brand merchandise in gaming, anime, and pop subcultures. Visit them at sanchi.com. Sanchi, the product of fans.
We would like to thank the Liberty City Anime Convention for allowing us to host 6 hours of our game show presentations. For more information about LCAC, visit www.libertycityanimecon.com for more information and to get tickets to the largest fan-run anime convention in New York City, now on sale. Tickets to 2017's Times Square event are expected to sell out soon. All information on the preceding program is accurate as of its recording date, August 20th, 2016. This has been Paul Williams, speaking for Lost River Productions, presents The Challengers.